Hello viewers, welcome to our channel. Today Dr. Sujata Stephen is with us, dietitian at Ashwatha Hospitals, Malakpet. Hello doctor.
Hello.
How are you doctor?
Yeah, fine.
Doctor, is there any particular diet for type 2 diabetes?
So type 2 diabetes is nowadays we see like our Indian population is more suffering with this type 2 diabetes, and we are leading also in the country. And Hyderabad has become a capital in India. So this is all because of lifestyle disorders and not taking proper meals and no timely meals, and irregular meals is the main concern. When you see the diabetes is going high in our population, and mostly people are going through a lot of stress and also overweight, obesity, and then also family history also adds on this. And these are the main concerns when you see diabetes, type 2 diabetes is high. Mostly we see in younger population, younger people like 20, 25 to 30 years, 40 years. So this type 2 diabetes is mostly diagnosed in adult people or teenage. Also nowadays we see in the teenage people also. So this is where we can also control this type 2 diabetes if we diagnose it in an early stage, like in a pre-diabetic stage. Okay, so the pre-diabetic stage where you can see that the HbA1c, which is a test which can know us like whether we are known diabetes or pre-diabetic and all. So when if you can diagnose in pre-diabetic stage, then it is easy to control without medication. With the diet, proper diet and exercise, you can control this diabetes and not getting into this diabetic known diabetic conditions. So that's why we have to, first thing, once you know that you have a family history of diabetes, or once you are diagnosed with diabetes, the first thing we have to do is like changing the diet. So what is the going wrong in our diet? We need to analyze it and then try to have low portion sizes in frequent intervals. So not having a large meals, because the large meals are the main concern when their sugars are going into high and low and all those things. So that's why we need to have a controlled portion of the meal and in frequent intervals, and then having along with this you should have a regular exercise. Okay. So this will help to keep in control, sugars in absolute control throughout the day. So then your sugars also will be in control, and when you see your HbA1c also will be in good control. So to keep our HbA1c in control, the basic thing we have to do is eating on time meals and a healthy nutritious food, and not going into all these processed foods and junk foods and all those things, and having good amount of protein in our diet, and having complex carbohydrates, not having a simple sugars, and good fiber. What is that we usually concern when it is comes in the diabetes and hypertension is fiber, is the which we are missing nowadays in our diets. So that is one more reason why we are entering into the diabetic conditions. So that's why what we have to do is take good amount of fibrous rich breakfast along with some protein, like whole cereals. Nowadays we see a lot of millets we get in the market, so you can include millets in the breakfast and in the lunch. And instead of rice and roti, so people are now worried about rice, including so rice and then wheat and all. So instead of rice, you have other options, like you have jowar is there, or other foxtail millets and other millets are there, quinoa is there, which you can include instead of rice. And then along with that, you should have plenty of vegetables. So all green leafy vegetables and with other vegetables, expect this root vegetables, you should be avoiding those root vegetables, like potatoes and all those things should be restricted. Mostly if sugars are in absolute control, you can have once in a while, but with the uncontrolled sugars, you need to avoid these things. And having fruit is also one more concern mostly. So fruits also have to be taken which are low calorie fruits and low glycemic index fruits are there, which you can include if your sugars are in absolute control. So mostly diabetes conditions where the sugars are in high, we need to check out your diet and then get back to your whatever extra calories we are going, then your sugars will come down to the normal. So that's why when you include one fruit, you can include in a day, like apple, oranges, papayas, and your guavas, and all these fruit you can include in your diet, one fruit in a day. And along with that, you have to include one fistful of nuts also will help you to keep your sugars in control, like almonds, pista, walnuts you can include to keep your stamina levels also. And these are the things which you have to include in between snacks. And then breakfast, you have to include one egg, boiled egg if you are a non-vegetarian, or if you are vegetarian, include some boiled peas or rajma chole kind of thing. And then your lunch should be a proper lunch with a low amount of, means controlled portion of rice, and then more of vegetables and some non-vegetarian, all chicken or fish you can include, or some whole dals you can include. And then your evening snack is very compulsory, because again 3 to 5 is a time where you get into low sugar levels. So that's why we have to have a 3:30, 1 healthy snack will help to maintain your sugars till evening 6 o'clock, like that. And then dinner should be early dinner and a light dinner.
Okay.
So this will help to keep your sugars in control. And evening also, if you go for a walk of 15-20 minutes, and morning once you wake up, try to have a 30 minutes of minimum walking. And if you are overweight and obese, you need to do more exercise. And then have a frequent interval meals will help to keep your sugars in control. So this will help the doctors also to cut down the medications. Mostly if diet is proper, then the medications will come down. So mostly people, what they do is they depend more on medications and they don't follow the diet properly. So that is where they are going into higher medications, and medicine will always have side effects either on kidneys, liver, and other organs will start affecting. So in diabetes, if you maintain with proper diet and exercise, you will not enter into the complication stages where kidney problems or heart problems, these are all complication stage where sugars are uncontrolled. So that's why we need to keep sugars in control, means having proper diet, healthy diet with good exercises, and this will maintain your sugars and you will never enter into that complication stage.
Okay, thank you so much, doctor. Thanks for the information. I hope you like this video. If you like it, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.